Here are 40 free APIs that you can use in your next programming project. Let's go. The Unsplash API lets you get free stock photos that are actually high quality and don't look like this.
This way you can write code that will let you query images for like your blog post or a relevant image in the group chat.
If you want to experiment with your own YouTube channel, then the YouTube API is pretty good for changing thumbnails, titles, etc.
You could do some A/B testing on some thumbnails to see which one gets the best click-through rate, do dynamic titles, whatever.
The classic modern day predicament. Is Family Guy on Netflix, Disney Plus, Paramount Plus, YouTube?
What I like about this one is that it's like a search engine based on the movies you give it. Great for building your own project on what to watch. Pricing is insane. 1,000 requests per month is good enough.
If you have a simple application that needs a database, don't set up a database.
Pantry lets you store 100 megabytes of JSON while attaching a CRUD interface to it. Kind of like TinyDB for Python if you've ever used it. Oh, and Canadian too.
This one is super niche, but Clearbit lets you get company logos if that's something you need.
So if I make a HTTP request, I can get the logo for Twitter. Again, if this is something you care about.
The Waifu API lets you build your anime wife for free.
My favorite endpoint is Uuify. So if I need to submit a pull request and look like I actually program, I can put it through there and I'm good to go.
Gamers, the Internet Game Database has a free API that you can use and it's owned by Twitch, which makes sense.
So it's actually really intense. Search for game versions, genres, covers, images, and more. My favorite Discord channel talked about using the IGDB to create a cool application. So it's free, why not?
The Discord API lets you build custom bots that you can use in your channels and, you know, get it to play games or whatever.
On my Discord channel, we have OGroid, which does about everything and level people up. It's a great way to engage your community. I mean, Midjourney does it. And there's SDKs for like every single programming language.
If you want to get up-to-date world news for your application, then this World News API has a free tier.
Okay, it needs to chill out though. 50 points per day, then no more calls. Prices are crazy expensive, so make sure you're making money before using this.
If you're testing an app, then you'll probably need a good mix of fake data.
Random Data Generator doesn't require an API key, and it lets you generate a ton of different models. It's probably just using Faker.js under the hood, but if you want to use that, then here you go.
Foreign exchange rates is annoying, but with this API, you don't even need an authentication key. But if you get the free one, then you'll also get historical data with it, so pretty worth it.
And any sort of payment context within your app, you're going to have to deal with foreign exchange rates. So this one is free and fair. Awesome.
Svix, I don't know, is a webhooks as a service API.
So when your app does something and you want to send some data to another app or somewhere else, this is a great way to do it. You have to sign up, but it's free and has some SDKs for like every language. So pretty awesome there.
Croaky lets you put in text and then it outputs as a diagram, either in a JPEG or PNG format.
So this database one right here is handy, but they have a ton of complex ones so you can use for a blog post or integration within your site. I love this. Thanks Exoscale for kindly offering two servers. Sounds funny. Only two servers.
Yes, you can connect to Google Docs with an API.
Some examples are using the data from your docs as JSON, creating an add-on for the side of Google Docs, and connecting to other services. Google Docs, who knew?
Status codes are boring, but HTTP status dogs are not.
I really like this 403 forbidden one. You can just call it by referencing the status code and there you have it. I'd be kind of annoyed if I had to wait a long time for this though.
This cute panda is the face of geocoding places.
So when you enter an address with text, how do you translate that into Google Maps or whatever map software you use? Well, Google Maps can for a big dollar. GeoKeo has 2,500 free API requests daily, which is a lot for a small app, so especially if you're testing.
I'm able to build a lot of these examples using AI with Machinet, which is the sponsor of today's video. Right now, GPT-4 is by far the best large language model. And with the Machinet extension in JetBrains, I can get help in my code quickly since it indexes the whole project and then embeds it so you can ask questions without having to copy and paste it in the prompt area. And since it has a 32K context length, I can just add a huge amount of the documentation and paste it right in, which helps me build this project out even further. And since this video talks a lot about creating projects with APIs, I can grab the GeoKeo API documentation and ask to make a simple project, which will find a way to integrate with what I already have. I've been using JetBrains my entire life, so being able to put GPT-4 right into my JetBrains editor is great. Thanks Machinet for sponsoring today's video. Ticketmaster has an API. interesting.
Since Ticketmaster has a monopoly on basically everything, this API is good to search for events in terms for discovery. Basically, what you can view on the app, you can do here, so it's somewhat useful.
The irony behind I love PDF is that I hate PDFs, actually with a burning, fiery passion.
I love PDF makes it easy to extract text, edit PDFs, remove passwords, compress, and way more. They have libraries in Ruby, Node, PHP, but REST is usually just good enough.
I tried so hard to find an API that could convert files easily, and this is the best one I got.
Cloud Convert will give you 25. 25, folks, that's it. If this is a functionality in your app, then this is definitely the cheapest option. But if it's only between two specific file types, just automate it with Python or something.
Okay. This one is kind of unique.
Ollama lets you run large language models on your machine, but it comes with an API that you can listen to through localhost. Llama 2, Mistral, or Lava is all available. So if you're building privacy-centric apps but want AI, this is awesome and free.
This API is called Free Dictionary API. I'll give you one guess.
This doesn't require an API key either, and is actually run off of donations, so props to them. You could probably use this to build a really simple app where if you highlight a word, it will tell you what it means without getting roasted in your group chat.
Hey, look, it's the API that you use to learn Python, Java, or React, and it's this far into the video?
Jokes aside, OpenWeather is goated. 1,000 API calls for free per day and very reliable. I mean, who actually needs weather data? I don't know. It could be a cool way to connect AI to determine what to wear or something. So I don't know, use it at your discretion.
If you want to build a training bot, kind of like what I did right here, then this is the API that I used for a lot of the core functions.
The technical terms like PE ratio, whatever, is all there with historical data. 25 requests per day. It's okay. They even have data on wheat, corn, and cotton. I guess in case the Amish people start becoming software developers.
Did I open source that yet? Yahoo Finance is the only thing keeping Yahoo alive. I'm convinced of it.
Now, this one is weird because I don't even know if they do have an API for Yahoo Finance. The Y Finance package in Python reliably, well, most of the time, get historical data on stocks. It honestly seems like a nightmare to maintain this, so props to the maintainer.
The deck of cards API is honestly kind of hilarious because it's like not that complex of a topic, really.
If you're wanting to make a game or a user interface involving cards, this is perfect. It has a lot of different endpoints to do different actions. And it's honestly pretty damn cute. An endpoint where you draw two cards, just so perfect. Then there's piles, shuffling decks, shuffling piles, listing cards in piles.
Okay, sorry, maybe it's a bit complex. I used to work with WordPress and I never realized this.
It has a REST API attached to it that you can query with. So if you want to start a website for a client or yourself, but also want to do that fancy TypeScript, React, Astro stuff, this is a great way of doing that. Honestly, without the plugins, WordPress is pretty great. I said it.
Spotify has a really popular API that you can use to retrieve artists, songs, the pennies that they pay artists every year.
If you created a serverless function that grabbed your latest listen to song every 30 minutes, then it'd be a cool little feature on your website.
Podcast Index lets you grab information on podcasts.
However, the part I care about the most is the transcript. It gives you the URL you can download and just have a lot of fun with. It's even timed too, so you can like do some fun things with AI or maybe do those annoying videos with the one word at a time thing.
DeepGram is a speech to text AI that is kind of like OpenAI's Whisper.
And what's really cool about this tool is that you can add timestamps for each word, summarize audio, sentiment analysis, surveillance. You do have to sign up for an account and get a key, obviously, but no credit card and 200 credit. Not bad at all, honestly. I built a project where it would speed up certain podcast hosts and slow down other ones.
Zen Quotes. I know you probably use this in your tutorial with the weather API.
You don't need a key, and honestly, it's a great way to maybe try out a new programming language or a silly Easter egg in your Discord bot or something. Beyond simple, call the API, get the quote, lots of different things you can do with it. I just learned Go with it.
Open Food Facts is awesome because you enter the barcode number and it'll give you all of the information on that specific item.
I actually built an app last week where I just completely remade a whole app from scratch, and it saves it into a database with the scores. It's pretty awesome.
Stripe. How else can you flex on YouTube?
The Stripe API is revolutionary. I don't really need to tell you much about it. It's really easy to get started with it and accept payments if you wanted to build a store or some financial automations, whatever. I mean, it's not free. 2.9% plus 30 cents of each transaction. If you want free, you could probably use crypto, but you'll lose money there.
Resend makes sending emails extremely easy.
It seems silly, but you should have seen the things I did to get emails to work in my applications. Simple integration in your code in like any language, as well as the ability to create email using React. I know this seems silly, but email still uses HTML table here, folks.
One last thing though, Resend. You're calling your reliable email infrastructure Resend? Am I the only one thinking this? Trace.mo is an API used to retrieve the anime series based off of the frame that you give it.
1,000 monthly quota? It's all open source too? Seriously impressive. I'm sorry, if you're a programmer and not an anime fan at this point, you're being lapped by these people. Just give up.
I'm throwing all of these APIs into one number on this list, and that is your favorite app.
Most of the times, software is like Notion, Obsidian, Jira, and for me, Todoist, have an API you can plug into. The reason I'm batching this into number one is because it's usually on the data you provide, and if that software isn't free, then the API usually isn't free.
Alpaca is the most popular way to create automated stock trading bots.
This API is really well documented and very popular amongst the US. For me, I couldn't sign up because I was Canadian. It has a ton of different SDKs you can use all across different programming language. You just need money to run it, which isn't free, but kind of is.
NASA has a ton of APIs and they're all awesome.
Where do I even begin with this? APIs for astronomy pictures, Mars weather, observation data. There's so much to explore here that I don't even know how I would use this. To be fair, I also do very stupid things. You don't need an API key, but it is recommended, and this data is some of the only data you can get regarding space. Maybe for video games or something, I don't know.
The MovieDB is like IMDb, but not owned by Amazon.
One of my favorite apps is Letterboxd, and it reminds me of how this API could create incredible experiences for movie lovers like myself. It's free for non-commercial use, so if you're building a small application that you and your friends want to use, have fun. And there's a lot of different wrappers and a ton of different programming languages.
DigiDates helps you deal with dates, like validating if a date exists, if it's a leap year, etc.
If you have a project that needs one tiny little date related function, dependencies like Arrow for Python or Moment.js for JavaScript are such overkill. So one API endpoint might be perfect for you.
Before number 40, if you're new here, make sure you give a subscribe. We just hit 500,000 subscribers and that's just amazing. So thank you so much. The Open Sky Network lets you track planes in real time.
Similar to those accounts that have been banned for it, for open data. It's available in Python and Java or just using the REST API.
Okay, let's deploy that waifu bot.